sam na putu za Melnik. To je mesto u kome se nalazi zamak koji vidite ovdje iza mene. To je zamak aristokratske porodice Lopković, Jiří Lopkovića. I ta porodica u tom zamku boravi od 14. veka. Beethoven je komponovao za porodicu Lopković 3., 5. i 6. simfoniju. Ovaj zamak im je bio oduziman nekoliko puta tokom Drugog svjetskog rata, da bi 1945. godine bio vraćen njima, pa je onda 1948. godine kad su došli komunisti opet bio oduzet i da bi se konačno vratio 2002. godine, a rekonstrukcija je počela i završena 2007. godine. Moj domaćin, gospodin Lopković, me čeka u zamku. Kako je to nekada bilo? Ovdje zamak, knez, a ovo i oko ovoga sve njegov. I samo se on sluša. Kakav mir. To je taj zamak. Divno je rekonstruisano. Poznat je po tome što ima i svoje vinograde i svoja vina i tu priređuje veliki broj događanja.
For 32 years of my life, I was George, and then I came to this country and I became Jiří.
Heard that the castle was returned to you,
yes.
which was in a way a big news, you know, in Europe.
That's correct. It was returned in 1991 to my father, who gifted then the property to me, and we are presumably one of the only country which has restituted all the properties to every Czech citizens, but I would say not only castles, but also land and farmhouses and houses to private individuals. So there are hundred thousands of people who have received their property back. Yeah.
When you really work in the castle and when you really take care of such a big property, because this is also for us, and this is, and then you know that this is not a fun, this is real work, and every day we work, and very hardly, and he worked 20 years like this.
Is this a children's room?
Yes.
I will tell you the real truth about this. There's a lot of things missing. What you see here is only, I would say, 30% to 40% of what was in our possession.
You should tell about the paintings. It was kicked in the face. It was by the communists. It was destroyed, the paintings, incredibly.
This is a new door here, which is completely historically remade. And this was a door which was made under communism, which unfortunately is the last door which I have to redo in this house. So this is for me also emotionally very important. Can I show you here?
Can we put the light on?
There's no light here. There's no light, no. Here is the furniture which has been restituted. That's the furniture as you see it, as it has been restituted, destroyed. You know, chairs from the 18th centuries with some inventory numbers. And so everything you see here is still to be refurbished and redo.
That you found the situation like this?
The house here was actually empty. We brought back from 32 different storages in the country, the furniture and the paintings and everything. I would say 60 to 70% of the furniture is disappeared. The paintings, luckily, because they are very good quality, I would say 90% of the paintings were restituted, but a lot of the porcelain, the silver, everything disappeared. So, you know, you asked me before how beautiful everything is, but it was much more, and the things have disappeared during the 50 years of mismanagement of the communists. And not only the things have disappeared, but unfortunately the houses have been destroyed very badly.
Funny thing is that you can, for example, this, you never can restore. You know, there is not possibility to restore this, but it has a number from National Heritage, and you cannot throw it away. You cannot, because this is protected by National Heritage. So all the pieces, all the little pieces, which there are numbers, which they don't know where they belong or what to do with them, you have to keep, because there is a number from National Heritage.
Do you know who did it by person?
But it's very difficult, you know, after 50 years. And it's not really our interest to follow this, because I think, and on the other hand, I must say, you know, the little history and the big history is that there were fantastic people who gave us things back after 50 years. There's some piece of furniture or porcelain which people brought or put in front of the door with a little note. We kept it for 50 years and we give it back to you. And we are very happy that you're back in the country. So there's also very nice stories about the restitution. And this is a Rococo a library which we're going to redo and put in the other castle. We're just working on doing there a 5-star hotel with a golf course. And that furniture is going to go back there with the library. So here we're in a dining room, and this is a Veronese. And you see it's a self-portrait of Veronese holding the cross and helping Jesus. So here we are in the chapel, this chapel of Saint Ludmilla. Saint Ludmilla was from Mielnik. This was her house in the 9th century. And she brought, because she became Christian, she brought the wine to Mielnik. And that's why we have wine, we're my winemaking. And here you see on the main altar, you see her and Bożywoj Przemyslid, who was the first, I would say, prince of Bohemia, who are becoming Christian. And when we arrived here in 1990 with my father, this room was the meeting room of the Communist Party. So there was nothing here what you see, and there were pictures from Stalin and Mao Zedong and people like this on the walls. And it's the first thing I've redone is to redo this chapel.
This is the river Moldau, Vltava in the Czech Republic, you say, the Elbe. And the Elbe is here, you know, and they are meeting there on the most important point in the Czech Republic. The biggest two rivers are meeting in the Mielnik castle. That's everyone learned in the school in the first class. 23 princesses and queen came here because this was the basic of the Czech country.
It's not only the last 1,000 years which are important, but it was always a very important history because of the two rivers and the water and the nature, which is incredible here. We have the richest agricultural land in the country. And that's why Father Cech, when he came on the Holy Mountain, he says, that is my land. Here is fishes, there's water, there's a lot of meat because it was game. And that's where we're going to install ourselves. And that's where the legend of the Bohemian country has started.
Mr. Lapkowitz, when you look to all this, and you look to this land, and you look back in your life, is it nicer than Switzerland?
Oh, yes. Definitely. And especially because it's mine.